Before going to actual anatomy of mulberry, let us know what is plant anatomy and the tissues present in the plant. Plant anatomy, it is a branch of plant science which deals with the study of internal structure of plants. It can also be termed as structural organization in plants. In the internal structure of any plant, we can find number of tissues. A tissue can be defined as group of cells having similar origin, structure, and function. The tissues present in the internal structure of plant are as follows. The plant tissues consists of meristematic tissue and permanent tissues. Meristematic tissue, they are undifferentiated mass of cells, show active division, present at the growing region of plant and contribute cells for plant growth. The cells are hexagonal or pentagonal, arranged compactly without intercellular space. Cell wall is very thin without secondary wall, and cells are interconnected by plasmodesmata. Nucleus is prominent and always found in divisional stages. Except mitochondria, all other organelles are in early stages of development. Cells do not store reserve food material. The main functions of meristematic tissues are, it helps in growth of the plant body, responsible for the formation of new organs like buds, flowers, leaves, etc., helps to heal the injured part of the plant body. Permanent tissues. Permanent tissues have attained the stage of maturity and they are derived from meristematic tissue. They have lost the capacity of cell division either temporarily or permanently. Cells of this tissue may be living or non-living. Permanent tissues are classified into two types, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. Simple permanent tissue consists of homogeneous mass of cells. They have lost the capacity of cell division either permanently or temporarily. There are three different types, namely parenchymatous tissue, collenchymatous tissue, and sclerenchymatous tissue. Parenchyma is often called ground tissue present in cortex, pith, mesophyll of leaves, rind of fruit, and endosperm of seed, also associated with xylem and phloem. It is a living, simple, permanent tissue with thin-walled cells. Cell wall is made up of cellulose. Cells are oval, spherical, hexagonal, with or without intercellular spaces, have large nucleus, vacuoles, developed organelles with reserve food materials. The main functions of parenchymatous tissues are, helps in storage of food and water, carries vital functions like respiration and photosynthesis. Parenchyma becomes meristematic and helps in secondary growth, involved in wound healing, associated with xylem and phloem, helps in conduction of water and food. Collenchyma tissue. Collenchyma is often called living mechanical tissue, is always hypodermal in position in dicot stem and midrib of leaf. Collenchyma is absent in monocots and in roots. Cell wall is made up of cellulose and pectin, and walls are unevenly thickened. Cell has nucleus, cell organelles and vacuoles, and intercellular spaces are rare. The main functions of collenchyma are, gives mechanical strength and support, involves in photosynthesis due to the presence of chloroplast, also performs vital functions like respiration. Sclerenchyma tissue. Sclerenchyma is often called dead mechanical tissue. They do not possess living protoplasm. Sclerenchyma cells are grouped into two types, fibers, sclerites. Fibers are elongated sclerenchyma cells with pointed ends. They are dead cells with lignified wall, do not possess living protoplasm, and compactly arranged without intercellular spaces. Fibers have pits on their wall. Main functions are, they provide mechanical strength and support, helps in seed dispersal. Sclerites are thick-walled, heavily lignified, hard cells of sclerenchyma. The main functions are, gives mechanical strength to soft tissues of leaves and some fruits. Complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissues are heterogeneous tissues made up of different types of cells, all of which coordinated to perform a particular function. These tissues are meant for conduction of water and food, hence they are also called as conducting tissues. There are two types of complex permanent tissues, namely xylem and phloem. These terms are coined by Nageli in 1858. Xylem is a complex permanent tissue which conducts water and mineral elements from root to leaves. Xylem tissue is grouped into two types based on the time of differentiation in plant body as primary xylem and secondary xylem. Primary xylem is differentiated in the primary plant body by procambium. Secondary xylem is differentiated after completion of primary growth by the activity of vascular cambium. Phloem is a complex permanent tissue which helps in conduction of food. Now let us see roots. Roots are radical, comes out from the seed coat in the form of soft structure and move toward the soil. It develops and forms primary root. Roots are non-green, underground, positively geotropic, hydrotropic, and negatively phototropic in nature. Roots do not bear buds, nodes, and internodes. Roots have unicellular root hairs. Roots are of two types, taproot and adventitious root. Taproot develops from radical and made up of one main branch and other sub-branches. The primary roots and its branches constitute taproot system. Example, dicot roots. Adventitious roots. In some plants, after some time of the growth of taproot, which arises from radical, stops, and then roots develop from other part of plant which are branched off, unbranched, fibrous or storage are known as adventitious roots and constitute fibrous root system. Example, monocot roots. Regions of roots. Morphologically, four distinct regions are present in roots. Root cap. It is a terminal structure and protects tender apex of root. Meristematic zone. Cells of this region are very small and thin-walled. They divide repeatedly and increase cell number. Elongation region. The cells proximal to meristematic zone undergo rapid elongation and enlargement and are responsible for rapid growth of roots. Maturation region. Cells proximal to region of elongation gradually differentiate and mature. Root hairs are present in maturation zone. The main functions of roots are fixation, absorption of water and minerals, storage of food, conduction of water, photosynthesis, and respiration. Roots of mulberry plants repeatedly branch and grow to form an organized root system. In the young mulberry plants, it is found that there is a thick, vertically descending root growing at the center. This is known as main root or tap root. From the main root, branching roots develop, and these branching roots form as primary, secondary, and tertiary roots. After giving rise to rootlets, they give rise to fiber roots at the tips. Young growing roots are found to grow innumerable root hairs at the anterior edges, which are soft and milky yellow in color. The root hairs are lost temporarily when the shoots and leaves are trimmed. Growing point at the root tip is covered by root cap. Root cap protects the growing point inside so that root tip is not rubbed and injured by soil particles. The outer cells of the root cap secretes a glutinous juice that help the root tip to extend smoothly forward, and root cap maintains certain thickness and shape. group of roots which grow by branching in this manner is called the root system. Root system spreads both horizontally and vertically with stump as the center. This type of spreading of the root system and distribution depth are called distribution of root system. Mulberry root system is greatly influenced by soil conditions. Since mulberry plant has deep root system, the soil should be good condition. For a healthy growth of root system, the soil should have a proper pore space and should have aggregated structure with rich air content. Roots of mulberry are either yellow or yellow brown in color. Young roots are yellow and the old roots are yellow brown in color. On the bark of the root, there are many lenticels arranged perpendicular to axis of the roots and they are scattered in the form of long lines. Mulberry is deep-rooted perennial plant. Transverse section of mulberry root shows the same structure as in other dicotyledonous plants root. The primary structure of root portion produced by primary tissue is called primary structure. When the transverse section of the mulberry root is observed, layout structure of each tissue is basically same as that of the stem. Transverse section of mulberry root appears circular in outline. From the outer layer to the inner, tissues are arranged in the order of epidermis, cortex, and the steel consisting of cambium, xylem, phloem, and pith. Epidermis located on the outermost layer of root is a single layered, consists of tubular shaped parenchyma cells closely arranged without intercellular space. Its outer walls are not cutanized and a few of the epidermal cells enlarge into root hairs. Water and mineral salt solutions from the soil enter the plant through the thin walls of the parenchyma cells. Below the epidermis, there is a large cortex lies between epidermis and steel, consists of layers of parenchyma cells. In the outermost layer of the cortex, the cells are compactly arranged. After the outer walls, the cells become phlegmized. The epidermal cells gradually die and the cortex takes the place of the epidermis to protect the cell. Cells in the middle cortex are arranged loosely with wider gaps between them. They constitute most of the cortex. The cortex innermost layer are inner cortex and here the cells are arranged compactly. Though these cells, water and food absorbed by root hairs enter the steel. There is a clear single layered endodermis made up of barrel shaped cells enclosing the pericycle and vascular bundles. The inner tangential and radial walls of these cells are thickened by Casparian thickenings. Endodermal cells close to the protoxylem do not have Casparian thickenings. Such endodermal cells are called passage cells. The steel is the central part of root located inside the cortex, consists of pericycle, xylem, phloem, and parenchyma cells. Pericycle is the outermost single layer made up of parenchyma cells, is able to split and produce lateral roots, carcambium and phellogen. The vascular bundles are diarch, sometimes triarch, radial and without cambium. Primary xylem located in middle of the root is arranged in the form of two opposing bundles called diarch xylem and rarely triarch xylem. Xylem vessels are the passages for water and mineral salts to pass through. Primary phloem is arranged alternately with primary xylem. The organic matter is transported through the sieve tubes in the phloem. In between vascular bundles, parenchymatous conjunctive tissue is present. Pith is parenchymatous negligible absent. Moreover, the phloem and cortex have bast fibers and the phloem has sieve tubes and the xylem has vascular vessels. Root also has a few milk tubes. The trunk, branches, and twigs of the mulberry tree are called the stem. Their main function is transporting water and mineral salts upwards and products of photosynthesis and other organic matters downwards. Under normal conditions, the length, size and color of mulberry branches and twigs and the length of their nodes are stable. Mulberry branches and twigs take three growing postures: erect, spreading and drooping. The erect variety has comparatively concentrated crown that ventilation is good on the plantation. Although the mulberry tree with spreading branches and twigs is able to make full use of the space, trees cannot be planted close together. The length and size of mulberry branches and twigs depend on variety, differences deriving from the age of the trees, the soil they are planted in, change of climate, pruning and cutting methods, methods of manure, application and management, etc. As far as shoot color is concerned, at the end of autumn, mulberry shoots display a characteristic coloration of the variety. The shootlets, which are in the process of growing, appear green because of the underlying chlorophyll in the epidermis. Later, when carcambium forms the periderm, periderm color is displayed in shoots. Color of the shoots can be dark brown, reddish brown, yellow brown, dark gray. Color of the shoots is carefully observed according to histological preparations, and it was found that shoot color is composed of the following factors like color of the cork layer, number of layers and their thickness, color thickness of the phelloderm and primary cortex, along with cuticle color, particularly the epidermal cells and cuticle thickness. There are many lenticels present on the surface of mulberry shoots. While the lenticels in the nodes are small and circular, those on the internodes are longitudinal, are elliptical and yellow brown in color. Again, on the right and left side of the bud, at the nodes as well as on three places just below the nodes, there are large lenticels. In fact, these are called the large lenticels. Lenticels serve as the outlets and inlets for water vapor and gases. Lenticels initially form as stomata on the new shoot's surface. Finally, they occupy the space just below the initial location. When observed under the ultramicroscope, lenticels in the early formative stages show the rupture of cork layer, which appear like the crater of a volcano. When old lenticels are observed under the microscope, cork layer is found to have ruptured up to the closing layer, and at the center, a large number of complementary cells are found to be scattered. Anatomy of mulberry stem is similar to that of any dicotyledonous stem. A transverse section of mulberry stem is circular in outline, shown as starting from outer part. It is arranged in the sequence of outer epidermis, middle cortex and inner stele, consists of cambium, xylem, phloem and pith. The tissue from epidermis to cambium is collectively known as bark. Shoot tissue is broadly classified into bark, xylem and pith. Epidermis is composed of single layered tubular shaped parenchyma cells closely arranged without intercellular space. Thick outer surface of the epidermis is covered by waxy cuticle layer. Some of the epidermal cells are drawn into unicellular hairs called trichomes, which protect the plant from injurious insects and also minimize the transpiration rate. These epidermal hairs are coarse and profuse in polyploidy species. Below the epidermis, multilayered cortex consists of three regions like hypodermis, general cortex and endodermis. Cortex is made up of coleoparenchymatous, colenchymatous and sclerenchymatous cells. Hypodermis consists of 2 to 3 layered colenchymatous cells immediately below the epidermis. Some of these cells contain chloroplasts and perform the function of photosynthesis. General cortex is made up of parenchyma cells with intercellular spaces. The outer layer of middle cortex may contain chloroplasts, and then it is called as cholenchyma. Cortex provides mechanical protection besides assimilation and storage. Endodermis is the innermost layer of the cortex, made up of barrel-shaped parenchyma cells. These cells contain starch granules and hence called starch sheath. The steel consists of pericycle, vascular bundles, conjunctive tissue and pith. Pericycle is multilayered and heterogeneous. It is clearenchymatous over the vascular bundles and parenchymatous between the vascular bundles. Vascular bundles are not surrounded by any sclerenchymatous sheath. Vascular bundles are usually few of nearly uniform size, arranged in a ring and are conjoint, collateral and open. Cambium is present between xylem and phloem. Xylem is endarch. Phloem is composed of sieve tubes, companion cells and phloem parenchyma. Parenchyma cells present between vascular bundles are called conjunctive tissue or primary medullary rays, and they perform the function of food storage and also help in transverse conduction of food material. Pith is a cylindrical body of tissue in the center of the axis, enclosed by vascular tissue chiefly made up of parenchymatous cells with intercellular spaces. Anatomical studies is the basis for classifying different varieties of mulberry based on structure of different parts like root, stem, etc. It plays a pivotal role in studying the various activities like nutrient uptake, arrangement of cells and their function, etc.